Our next speaker is Bruce Holstein.
I'm going to give you a little different viewpoint. The posters that were taken down were clearly political, and I applaud the principal, the school administrators, the school attorneys for reinforcing your policy of no political activity in the classrooms. The policy, which appears in Section 3 of Political Activities of Carroll County Public School Employees, reads in part, "No employee shall engage in political activity while on the job during working hours." The teachers who brought in the political posters convinced many students that the posters were about diversity, which is not totally true, as they were identified on the Amplifier website as political and used to protest against President Trump on Inauguration Day. The Carroll County Public School System decision makers, you got it right. The teachers got it wrong. To the student representative, Mr. Johnson, sitting up there, you can learn a lesson from these posters. And that is that your classmates were used by the political left to demonstrate about diversity, when in fact, the real issue was about certain teachers not following school policy. Diversity is defined by Webster's as the condition of being different. So what are you all celebrating? We're all different. The diversity issue was a straw man. And in case you aren't familiar with that term, it means a fake issue designed to draw attention away from the real issue. Webster's defines it as a weak or imaginary position, as in an argument set up to serve as cover for a questionable transaction. You may want to let your fellow students know how they were used. The United States was founded by immigrants. That is, people who came here legally. The United States Constitution was written to draw people together, not to separate them by differences. The motto of E Pluribus Unum means from many, one. The five of you sitting up there have a chance to teach students about the Constitution. Hillsdale College has a free online course, and they also have it on DVDs for a few dollars. I suggest you add a course in high school about the Constitution so students can learn about the genius of our founding fathers in creating a system of checks and balances which has survived for more than 200 years. I also have a suggestion about your communications with parents regarding school issues. You send out emails to parents when you want money at the budget time. You tell them about what's going on and what sacrifices have been made. I think you should do the same thing with other issues, too. I found out by accident that the state was considering changes to their COMAR regulation for multiculturalism. Superintendent Guthrie was kind enough to send me the contact information so I could submit my comments about the proposed change. Unfortunately, the comment period had closed. Nevertheless, the five of you could still make a policy that proposed changes to county or state rules and regulations should be broadcast to parents via email to provide them an opportunity to submit their comments if they would like to do that.
Thank you, Mr. Holstein.